So in this lecture we are going to discuss about the determinant. So determinant exists for only square matrix. So some important points, if you remember, then you can easily solve the problems based on determinant. So determinant of AB, the determinant of AB is equal to determinant of A and determinant of B. The next one, the determinant of a transpose matrix. Okay, so if matrix is given A, then if you are going to calculate the determinant of A and if you are going to calculate the determinant of transpose matrix, then that both determinant will give the same answer. Next one, the determinant of KA is equal to K power N and the determinant A, where N is the order of matrix. Then the fourth one important point is determinant of skew matrix is nothing but is equal to 0, because the skew matrix we can define the A transpose equal to minus A. So the example of the skew matrix is 0 minus H minus F minus G and H F G and 0. So if you are going to, if you calculated the determinant of this skew matrix, you will get the answer is 0. Next one is important point is that determinant of diagonal matrix. If matrix A is defined A equal to Aij, then this Aij equal to 0 if I is not equal to 0. That means we already discussed about the diagonal matrix in the last lectures. Okay, so if you calculate the diagonal determinant for the diagonal matrix, you will get the product of the diagonal element. So here I am going to give one example, the determinant of matrix A. If that matrix is diagonal, see, diagonal is nothing but the Aij equal to 0 if I is not equal to 0. That means these elements are I not equal to 0. So that is the reason these elements have the 0 values, and this is a non-zero element. So this is the diagonal element. So if you are going to calculate the determinant of this diagonal matrix, that is nothing but the product of Aij. So that means what? The product of this diagonal element. Okay, so the determinant for this A matrix is nothing but 1 into 2 into 3. So this is nothing but 6. If we are going to calculate the, if we take the fourth order, so nothing but 1 0 0 0. This is the square matrix, because I already mentioned that determinant only exists for the square matrix. So this is nothing but the multiplication of this diagonal element will give the answer for 24. Next one important point is the determinant for the triangular matrix. So diagonal, how the diagonal matrix similar only triangular matrix also. In this triangular matrix we are having two type of triangular, one is upper triangular, another one is lower triangular. So triangular matrix also determinant is nothing but the product of Aij. Aij means I equal to j. That means the determinant of this triangular matrix is nothing but A11 into A22 into A33. That is nothing but, this is A11, A12, A22, A33. And this is one of the example for upper triangular matrix. This upper triangular matrix we already discussed. This is the upper triangular matrix and this is the lower triangular matrix. Okay, so in either upper or lower triangular matrix, the determinant is nothing but the product of this diagonal element. So we can remember that either diagonal or triangular matrix, the determinant is nothing but the product of the diagonal element. Okay, next one important point is the determinant of orthogonal matrix is plus or minus 1, either plus or either minus 1. Okay, and one more important point is determinant of AB is equal to determinant of PA if A and B are have the same order. Okay, and one more is A power N is equal to determinant of A whole power N. N is nothing but order of matrix. Okay, then next one point is if determinant equal to 0, then A is called the singular point. Okay, and one more point is if any two row or column are same, then identity, then the determinant is nothing but 0. Okay, so this point will help you to solve the problems in the entrance, because in many of the entrance they will give the matrix, then using this point you can easily select the options. Okay, next one is one important point is if any two rows or if any two rows or columns are interchanged, then the determinant of the matrix have the same magnitude but in opposite sign. Okay, so if I am giving one example, then you can easily understand. So if you assume the matrix A equal to 1 2 3 4, so if you calculated the determinant for this matrix is nothing but So the 4 minus 6 is nothing but minus 2. Okay, so this is the parent matrix. Then if you change, interchange the row and columns. So if you interchange the row and columns, then you will get matrix like this: 3, 4, and 1 and 2. Here I interchange the row. So this is the matrix, second matrix. So if you calculate the determinant for this matrix, this is nothing but 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. Okay, so you can see here, so in this matrix, this matrix determinant is minus 2. These elements are equal to this element only, but only we interchange the row and columns, then we are getting the same magnitude but a different sign of the matrix. Okay, this is nothing but A equal to 1 1 3 2 and 0 5 minus 6. Next one is 2 7 8. Okay, so in this lecture I am going to give you two different methods to finding the determinant. If you like any one method, you can follow that. Okay, so if you take this one, this is 1, so just avoid this column and this row, so just multiple 5 8s are 40, and this is formula minus, and this is minus into plus is minus plus. Next one is 7 into 6 is 42, right? Next, this is plus, first term this is minus, this is plus term, so just put minus 3, and you avoid this one and this one, this columns and this row, so 0 into 8 is nothing but 0, and formula minus, and this plus and minus is plus, so 6 into 2 are 12. Okay, so next one is plus 2. Next, just avoid this column and this row, just multiply 0 into 7 is 0, and 2 into 5 is nothing but 10. Okay, so if you solve this mathematics, you will get the result 26. Okay, so this is the normal method. And another one more easy method I will give you. If you interested in this method or either that method, you can follow. Okay, so another method is just you write these all values like this: 1 3 2, and just you write this 1 3 2, and again you start 1 3, so 5 times you have to write 1 3. So first this 3 time you write, then you start this 1 term, 4th term, this is 5th term. Similar here also, 0, 5, minus 6, next this is first term 0 and 5. Similar this also, 2, 7, 8 and 2, 7. Okay, so this is the order of writing. And you see, you have to multiply 3 terms. So you just first multiply these 3 terms. So 5 into 8 is 40, and 40 into 1 is 40, and next you multiply these 3 terms. So 3 into, if you multiply these 3 terms, you will get minus 36, and multiply these 3 terms, you will get plus 0, right? Because 0 is there, plus 0. So same similar things. So this is 1 term only is there, this is 2 term only is there, so just multiply these 3 terms, you will get minus 20, and next you multiply these 3 terms, you will get plus 42. Next these 3 terms will give you 0. Okay, so plus, to just add it, you will get 26. Okay, so you can use either this method or this method. Okay, if you are very familiar with this method, you follow. Otherwise, this is all simple multiplications. First, you have to remember the way of writing this element. Okay.